You've lost or recovered your data. Now what? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. As I wrote the article that accompanies this video, I looked like I was going to have the unpleasant situation of having to send an email that I really didn't want to send. Quote, I tried everything I could, but I could not salvage the data on your disk drive. Sometimes we get lucky, which is why I tried it all. Sadly, that was not to be this time. So, what next? In this case, it was a friend 4 terabyte SATA laptop disk. Pretty ordinary, slightly larger than usual right now, 4 terabytes for a laptop, and it just stopped working. It had been taken to a couple of stores, technicians looked at it, and a couple of them even tried things, but ultimately they all threw up their hands. Their next suggestion was to send it to a data recovery service that could cost anywhere between $400 and $2,500. Before my friend decided whether to do that, I offered to have a look at the drive. I hoped that the latest version of SpinRite would have some luck. It was not to be. The drive would sometimes appear and sometimes not, and when it was temporarily accessible, it was excruciatingly slow. On those rare occasions where I got SpinRite to even start, it got less than 0.1% in before the disk would stop responding. The disk failure was more than SpinRite, or I, could handle. Now, the scenario I've just described is really not that unusual. I don't want to say that there's a rash of disk failures. There isn't. They're probably more stable, more solid than they've ever been in our history. But of course, we're using so many more of them these days. Disk failures happen, and the cost of that failure is often very, very high. As I often say, disks can die, they can die with no warning, and they can die completely with no hope of recovery. If it happens to you and you're not prepared, you're likely to lose whatever was on that drive forever. 95% of it might be easily replaceable or irrelevant, but that last 5%? Losing that can be extremely painful, and I've seen this over and over again. So after throwing up our hands on this disk, or even if we had dodged a bullet and been able to recover the data, what next? What next is easy. Start planning for the next time. Back up. Please don't tune out. I know I talk about this a lot, but that's because it's important. I keep running into situations exactly like this where everything would have been a complete non-issue had there been some kind of a backup in place. Planning for the next failure means planning for that failure to be a non-issue. Here's how you tell. Imagine your laptop, your computer, your cloud storage account just disappeared without notice and without hope of recovery. If that means you would lose important stuff, then you're not backed up. If it's in only one place, it's not backed up. So yeah, of course, how do I back up is usually the next question. There are so many different approaches to backing up. That makes it both easy and hard. There are so many decisions to make, we end up freezing and doing nothing. So here are a few alternatives. Every so often, copy your important files somewhere else. An external hard disk is a great place to start. The more important the data, the more often you should make sure that that backup is up to date. Keep your important data in a cloud service like Dropbox or OneDrive or Google Drive or Proton Drive or any of many others. If you lose the account, the files are still on your PC. And if you lose the computer, the files are still online. Install a backup tool like Macrium Reflect or EaseUS Todo. Have it make automated full image backups to your external hard disk periodically. While I greatly prefer that last one, and it's what I truly, truly recommend, any of those techniques, and probably several others, would be better than not backing up at all. Back up, please. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/173072. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.